four gospel writers, Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. Tell us about the events that took place on that first Sunday, that Easter Sunday, so long ago. But when you look at Matthew, Mark, and Luke, and John's story, you notice something very significant about Mark's story. What is significant is something that Mark left out of his story. And the other three gospel writers included into their stories. Like all the other three gospel writers, Mark tells us that the women went to the tomb, and there they saw the tomb was open. And going inside, they see this angel, this man dressed in white. And like all the other gospel writers, Mark also tells us that this angel tells the women that Jesus isn't here, and that's why the tomb is empty, and he's been risen. And like all the other gospel writers, Mark also says that this angel tells the women, go and tell the disciples that he's going to Galilee, and there you will see him. But at that point, Mark's story suddenly becomes different than the other gospel writers. Because Mark says that the women leave the tomb and they say nothing. Do you think they say nothing to no one because they were afraid. Now, many years later, after Mark writes his gospel, his story about Jesus, someone in the early church took Mark's story and tacked on an additional ending, like an epilogue, if you will. They tacked on an additional ending because there were no resurrection appearances in Mark's story. And so they tacked on three separate resurrection appearances into Mark's story. But Mark didn't write it that way. Mark ends his story abruptly, with the women leaving and not saying anything to anyone. So why? Why doesn't Mark say anything about the resurrected Christ? Why doesn't Mark, like the other gospel writers, tell us some stories where Jesus, the resurrected Lord, appears to his disciples? Why doesn't Mark do that? I submit to you, he doesn't do it because he's intentionally ending his story abruptly. He purposefully leaves out resurrection stories. But why? Why would Mark do that? The answer is found when you study Mark's gospel. You see, when you study Mark's gospel from beginning to the end, you begin to see a major theme in Mark's gospel. And that major theme is you need to believe before you see. Do you hear that? Give me an amen if you heard that.
Yeah.
You need to believe before you see. Time and time again, throughout Mark's gospel, the people come to Jesus, and the Jewish leaders come to Jesus, and they say, we want you to do some signs and miracles and wonders so that we can see and then believe. Even when Jesus is on the cross, let me read to you a short passage of Scripture. Jesus is on the cross, and the crowd says this, he saved others, they said, but he can't save himself. Let this Christ, this King of Israel, come down now from the cross that we may see and believe. Mark says it doesn't work that way. You need to believe in order to see. And that's why Mark doesn't tell us about resurrection appearances. He wants you first to believe. And that's also why Mark has the women saying to the disciples, now pay attention here. Go and tell the disciples, said the angel, to go to Galilee, and there you will see him. In other words, the women are basically told to tell the disciples, look, if you believe that he has risen, then go to Galilee, and you'll see him there. Mark suggests throughout his whole book, you need to believe, and then you'll see. But we want to see first, and then we'll believe. Mark says, it won't work that way. You need to believe. Then your eyes will be opened, and you will see. This past Tuesday night, the men's group from our church here went to Phoenix Middle School for their soup supper. It was a fundraiser at Phoenix Middle School. And it was all-you-can-eat soup, and that's right up Reagan-Mize Alley. And besides that, you get to take that bowl home with you, you know, that the kids have made, you know, a pottery bowl there. So, I mean, it's a good deal. For $5, you can't lose on that one. So we went there and had a real nice meal, great soups. Then we came back to church, where we watched our final segment entitled Dare to be Different. It's a video segment through our Right Now Ministry library. Tony Dungy is the presenter in that video series. Tony Dungy, of course, is the Super Bowl coach from the Colts. He's also on Sunday Night Football. He's also a very devout Christian. And in that presentation, Tony Dungy said that one night he got a telephone call from a friend of his. And the friend said, Tony, I need you to come over and visit with my son. Tony said, why? Why do I need to come over and visit with your son? And the friend said, well, his fiance was killed in a car accident. Now he's just beside himself. He's depressed. He's talking suicide. I need you to come talk to him. So Tony went. He spent some time with this young man. And one of the things Tony said in that video presentation that he said to the young man is, you need to draw close to God. You need to believe. Did you hear that word? Believe. That God will walk you through this mess. Well, after Tony left, that young man took his advice. He drew close to God, believing that God would somehow walk him through that terrible mess of losing his fiancée. And you know what happened? The young man began to see God walking with him. The young man became aware of God's presence. God walked with that young man through the valley of the shadow of death and brought to him new life. Now, how can all this happen? The young man believed, and then he began to see. Amen? Amen. A couple of nights ago, I talked with a young mother of four. Her husband died of cancer. As a church, we prayed for her husband when he was sick. And so I asked this young mother of four, how is she doing raising these four young kids? She said, it's rough. I would have expected that. But she said, you know, God is so good. God is so good. I believe when my husband died, that God would walk me through, that God would direct me, that God would give me strength. And yes, it's been rough, and there have been low times. But I have seen God over and over in my life since the death of my husband. I have seen God gently preparing me for this new chapter in my life as a single mom. You need to believe before you see. And that's what Mark wants us to see on this Easter day. We live in a time where there's just a lot of darkness and turmoil and destruction. It seems like every week there's some terrorist bombing someplace in this world of ours. And innocent lives are just taken, and there's so much pain. And every week, somewhere in this country, somebody picks up a gun because they're angry about something and they decide to just knock off innocent people. And there's more pain and sadness. And just about every week, there's some natural disaster someplace. Earthquake, fire, flood, tornado, and again, so much loss, grief, and sadness. Every week, mud is slung, and questions are raised about the remaining political candidates who are running for president. And every week, someone's diagnosed with cancer and begins chemotherapy. There's just a lot of sadness and turmoil. But, if we believe that God can bring life out of death, if we believe that God can bring strength out of weakness, if we believe that God can bring hope where there's only despair, then we begin to see God in the midst of that cancer diagnosis and chemotherapy. We begin to see God working in the midst of cleaning up after that horrific natural disaster. We begin to see God working with those who rally around families who have lost their loved ones through a mass bombing or through a mass shooting. We begin to see suddenly God at work in life. And when we see God, hope springs forth. And strength for us to continue to walk the road of faith. The angel told the women, go tell the disciples that they'll see Jesus if they get to Galilee. Mark doesn't tell us anything from that point on, remember? He ends abruptly. So if all we had was Mark's original gospel, we wouldn't know if the disciples ever did see the resurrected Lord. But fortunately, the other gospel writers tell us. They tell us that the disciples do go to Galilee, and there they see. They believed, and they went, and they saw. And Mark says, when you believe, you'll see God as well, working in the midst of life. Thanks be to God for this wonderful day, the wonderful gift of resurrection. Amen?
Amen.
Let's bow for a word of prayer.